Hey, what's up, y'all? It's the Dom. I'm back at it again with another hot topic for my Doms out there. So I'm going to go ahead and jump in. You know what I'm saying? What I want to talk about today is I'm going to talk about seduction. All right. Seduction is going to be very important if you're a Dom, because, you know what I'm saying, if you out here dating and if you want to build rotations and be able to, you know what I'm saying, attract films in your life and things like that, you definitely have to master being able to be seductive, okay? So we're going to jump into what that looks like for a Dom, okay? So the first thing I want to go over with seduction is the whole thing with seduction and how to get a femme to want to pursue you, to want to date you. You know what I'm saying? First of all, it's all going to be based on the way that you make her feel. All right. See, with femmes, when you're dealing with femmes, keep in mind that it is emotional. You know what I'm saying? It's all about the emotions. So if you can tap in on her emotions, and if you can make her feel a certain type of way, that's how you are going to build the attachment with the femme, okay? So in order to make her feel that connection with you and to feel a certain type of way, you have to know how to talk to the femme. You have to know what to say, you know what I'm saying, when you're talking to a femme, whether that's, you know what I'm saying, over the phone, or whether that's when you are approaching the femme to say she's giving you some choosing signals. When you're approaching the femme, you have to know what to say and how to say it. So with that being said, when it comes to seduction, the first thing to my doms out there is you gotta work on your tone when you're talking to a femme, okay, that you are attracted to, that you want to date, put in rotation. You cannot talk to this femme like you're talking to one of your friends or one of your homies. You know what I'm saying? You have to talk to this femme in a way that's going to make her feel sexy. You know what I'm saying? You have to seduce her. So when you're talking to a femme over the phone, you want to make sure that the tone that you're using is a seductive tone. It may be lower than your regular talking voice, but you have to make her feel sexy when she's talking to you. You know what I'm saying? You have to make her feel like she is wanting to strip off all her clothes, you know what I'm saying, and have sex with you right then and there. You have to get her in that mood in order for you to, for one, you know what I'm saying, to be able to build an attachment with her and to be able to put her into rotation. So keep in mind, it's all about what comes out of your mouth, the way that you're talking to her, the way that you might be looking at her, you know what I'm saying? As far as what comes out of your mouth, you know, you never want to argue with your femme. You know what I'm saying? If she is testing you a lot, you know what I'm saying? And let's say she wants to pick an argument, you let her know, you know, baby, we ain't gotta argue. We can sit down like adults and, you know what I'm saying, try to figure this thing out. You just want to make sure that you're never arguing with your femme. Let's say that, you know what I'm saying, she tries to ask you a question on a date, you know what I'm saying, like, you know what I'm saying, like, why you wear that shirt? You know, maybe she's trying to test your confidence. You just say, you know, I like this shirt. You like it, baby? You know what I'm saying? You just have to keep that masculine frame, even when you're trying to seduce this femme to build that attachment, all right? Another thing with seduction, all right, is, you know what I'm saying, it leads me to the next point, which is masculine frame. I teach my doms, you definitely want to, you know what I'm saying, hold on to that masculine frame. You know what I'm saying? I know that it's hard to, you know what I'm saying, keep that frame, you know what I'm saying, the whole time when you're with that fam. So you just have to be mindful, you know what I'm saying, when you're with that fam, that you're as much as possible standing to your masculine frame. And this is just going to take practice. You know what I'm saying? You just want to make sure, like, when you're going on dates with these fams, that you're staying, you know what I'm saying, very confident, that you're not letting anything that she does knock you off your square. If she shows up late on a date, you check her. You say, you know, I don't like waiting on people. And maybe have her to get the first round of drinks. There's nothing wrong with that. You know what I'm saying? But again, you want to stay in that masculine frame. And that's with anything. Because, see, the thing is, you never know. You know what I'm saying? Like, let's say you're going to a club. You know what I'm saying? You never know what femmes are watching you or are observing you. You know what I'm saying? So if you're, you know what I'm saying, not in that frame, well, you can miss out on a lot of ass because you're not in that masculine frame. And let me explain why a masculine frame is much better than like a goofy comedic frame. Because I've been there too. I've been the dom that wanted to make the girl laugh. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to be the jokester. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to stand out in the crowd, be a little goofy. You know what I'm saying? Be entertaining. Well, the thing is that when you are using that comedic, goofy type of frame versus that masculine frame, it's easy for her to test you. You know what I'm saying? Because she looks at it like, oh, you're trying to tap dance for me. You're trying to entertain me. Where you should feel confident enough in your skin where you ain't got to do none of that. You ain't got to do no entertaining. You know what I'm saying? If you do make any jokes, just make sure that it's not like goofy. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you're maintaining that masculine frame. Because again, when a femme is in her feminine energy and you're in your masculine energy, her attraction for you is going to grow. It's going to be there. You know what I'm saying? So I always say to try to stay in that masculine frame. You know what I'm saying? Don't do the goofy comedic route. I mean, if that's what you want to do, then you could do that. But I always found that when I'm more of in a masculine frame rather than in a goofy frame, I do attract more femmes that way. So I just say, you know, keep up with that masculine frame. So when you're on a date with this femme, make sure that, you know what I'm saying, you are very confident that you know what I'm saying? That's why you want to familiarize yourself with the locations that you're taking these femmes to on dates. Because if you go to a place and you don't know anything about their menu or anything like that, well, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be hard to exemplify that confidence when you're struggling through a menu trying to figure out what you're going to eat. So make sure that you know these things. You know what I'm saying? It's chess, not checkers. You know what I'm saying? And then another thing, the reason why I say you want to remain in that masculine frame is, I'm going to be honest with y'all, it's a lot of, you know what I'm saying, studs. And I say studs because we're just going to generalize all together. I'm not talking about doms. I'm not talking about soft studs. I'm talking about studs all together. It's a lot of studs that, you know what I'm saying, don't have that masculine frame. And there's nothing wrong with that. You know what I'm saying? If that's, you know, makes, you know what I'm saying, that's okay for them. But I'm saying as a dom, the way that you're going to attract more femmes and be able to seduce them is by maintaining that masculine frame, because this makes you a rare commodity. Okay. It's very rare these days. You know what I'm saying? Studs are more, and you know what I'm saying, they're more feminine now. Like back in my day, I remember as a stud, you could not have long hair and consider yourself as a stud. Your hair had to be faded. You know what I'm saying? And I got long hair and that's okay. But I'm saying that it's very rare these days for a stud to be very masculine. You know what I'm saying? It's very rare. You're going to find that in a lot of the older studs. A lot of the old head studs are more masculine, whereas the new generation, they're more in tune with their feminine side. So again, it's going to be very rare. You're going to be a rare commodity. And the thing about being a rare commodity is that's what people want. People want that rare commodity, something that you can't get just from anywhere. You know what I'm saying? That's what's going to make you very attractive to these femmes out here, is that you are so masculine and that you know what I'm saying? It's very rare. So that's a good thing when it comes to seduction. When you're in that masculine frame and you're talking to her in that low voice and you like, you know what I'm saying, baby, won't you come over here and sit by me, you know? And you know what I'm saying? You're making her feel some type of way, and that's very rare, you know? So make sure that you stand in that masculine frame. Another thing that you want to do in order to be seductive and remain, you know what I'm saying, be able to seduce these femmes is it's all about, you know what I'm saying, the experience. What I mean by that is that, you know what I'm saying, you want to take her somewhere where it does give that romantic vibe. You know what I'm saying? Because how can you seduce a femme, at the movies? I say movies is not a good place to take a femme, because again, you know, even though it's dark and you would think, okay, this is the perfect place, the thing is that if this is a first date and you're at a movies, well, ain't gonna be no freaking 9 times out of 10 at the movie theater. You know what I'm saying? She's gonna be, you know, watching the movie, and then you really can't conversate with her because she's watching the movie. So she ain't gonna know about your seductive frame, about your charm, about your confidence, nothing like that. Because again, you know what I'm saying, you both are in the movies. She's more than likely watching the movies. You're side by side. You're not facing each other. So there's really no type of chemistry or bond that could, or attachment that could be built. So it's all about the experience. So what I always recommend to do is that when you're dating, you know what I'm saying, first date, of course, you know what I'm saying, it's okay to take it to a bar or a pub. But again, you know what I'm saying, there's, you're having drinks, so you're able to have these conversations. You're able to be seductive while you're conversating with this femme. You know what I'm saying? So those are okay. Parks are okay. Places like that. You know what I'm saying? You definitely want to make the date an experience. You know what I'm saying? You don't want it to be anything where it's like friendly, a friendly vibe. You know what I'm saying? Like, you want to make sure that the dates are very, like, you know what I'm saying, have that romantic mood to them. So again, you know, and then once a girl is in your rotation, you know what I'm saying, meaning you've been dating her and, you know, you've had sex with her, it's okay to take her ass out to eat for a meal. And then, you know, again, when you're taking her out to a restaurant, make sure it has that romantic feel, because after the date, more than likely, you know what I'm saying, you're trying to get her back to your place, you know. So again, make the date an experience. You know, that's what I always say, when you're on the date, make sure that you dressing nice. You know, you don't want to wear no t-shirt or a ball cap out on the date. You know what I'm saying? Make sure that you dress nice, things like that. So definitely making an experience. And then the next thing that I would say as far as seduction goes, is that in order to be able to seduce a femme, I want to let my doms out there know that you have to be attracted to her. You know what I'm saying? Like, and so this is the reason why I say this, because let's say you meet a femme and she's maybe a 5 at, you know what I'm saying, maybe a 6 at best, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be hard for you to seduce this femme because you're not all that attracted to her. So when you're alone with her, you know what I'm saying, let's say you got her back to your crib, you're alone with her and things like that, keep in mind, you're not going to be able to just, you know, jump in and have sex with her. I mean, maybe some girls you could just do that too, but more than likely a femme has to get comfortable when she's at your place. You know, you might have to conversate a little bit, then you go into seducing, you know what I'm saying? Then you go into, come over here, baby. You might have to do a little foreplay with her, you know, kiss her on the neck, things like that. So with that being said, if you're not attracted to her, it's going to be hard for you to get in that mood to seduce her. And then, you know what I'm saying, it's going to be hard for you to get her in the mood. So make sure that when it comes to seduction, it is a femme that you're attracted to. You know what I'm saying? As doms, we don't have to just settle for whatever. We don't have to just settle for films that we're not attracted to. You know what I'm saying? That's why I say do the self-improvement. You know what I'm saying? This is going to be able to attract the films that you want, the bonnies that you want. And I'm talking about, these are doms. You know what I'm saying? So with self-improvement comes that, because it's giving you more confidence. You're making some money. You feel like you ain't just got to settle for whatever. You know what I'm saying? You feel like you're worth that bonnie or that dime. You know what I'm saying? So definitely, you know, when it comes to films, make sure it's a film that you are attracted to, that you have high attraction to as well, so you can be able to seduce her, all right? So I just want to give y'all a video about seduction. Again, you got to make sure that it's all about how you making that film feel, how you talk to her. You know what I'm saying? Are you talking to her in a friendly mode? Is your tone like a friend, or is your tone more like, yeah, baby, you know what I'm saying? Like, daddy gonna make it all right for you, you know what I'm saying? Come on over here, let me rub your back, you know what I'm saying? Are you talking like that to her, you know what I'm saying? Or is it more of a friendly vibe, you know? You want to make sure, again, that you are always in that masculine frame, because, again, as a femme, she's in that feminine frame, so she's automatically going to be attracted to how masculine you are, how confident you are, how you're not letting any of her shit tests get to you, you know what I'm saying? So versus that comedic and goofy route, which is okay. I mean, if that works for you, that works for you, but I'm saying most of the time with femmes, they do want that masculine or that more mature frame. So I would say go that route. Also be mindful of the places that you're taking these femmes. Make sure when you're taking her out on a date that you are giving her an experience, and you don't have to spend a lot of money. I mean, you know, hell, just taking her ass to like Starbucks or something, which I probably wouldn't take a girl to Starbucks unless she didn't drink, but taking her ass to Starbucks and then maybe, you know what I'm saying, y'all go outside and walk around and conversate, you know, that's building the romance right there. You know what I'm saying? You ain't gotta be, you know what I'm saying? You ain't gotta spend a bunch of money to make the date an experience. Okay. And we'll get more into like how, you know, you should set up your dates and things like that. And then, like I said, also, you got to make sure that the femme that you're trying to seduce, that you are attracted to, you know, if you're not really attracted to a femme, it's going to be hard for you to seduce her, for you to even get in that mood for one, and her to get in the mood. So it's going to be really awkward. So those are the things that I would suggest to follow when it comes to seduction with these femmes, you know what I'm saying? So I want to just leave y'all with that, all right? All right, it's the Dom.